This is the presentation for the tissues level of organization, and we're going to start with an overview of the types of tissues and talk a little bit about how tissues heal in this section. In studying the tissues, we're going to concentrate on how we classify them into different types. So most of this whole presentation for this chapter is going to be about how the different types of tissues are separated into these groups that we see here. We'll look more closely at various parts within it. But before we get there, we're going to talk about what the types of tissues are themselves in some detail. This is a list of the four types of tissues. They each have specific functions associated with them, but for each major class, these are the functions that we usually think of. First off, there's epithelium, which is found covering the outside of or lining the inside of most organs. Now, the most obvious covering epithelium is the epidermis of your skin, but also there's a lot of lining on the inside of things. Not necessarily everything is associated with a covering or lining epithelium, but in a lot of situations we do see it. There are other functions that we associate with epithelia. Then we have connective tissues, which is actually a slightly confusing group of tissues, and there's not a really better way to describe them as a group than being connective. But we'll see when we look at those in more detail that there is more to be said about that. Then there's muscle tissue, which is specialized for contraction. When it shortens, it generates force. And then nervous tissue, which is specialized for communication. Now, actually, there are aspects of communication in all the different types of tissue, from the very obvious things like glandular tissue secreting hormones, or connective tissue, which includes blood and white blood cells communicating for immune function. But nervous tissue we often think of as being the most important communication aspect of our body. It's sending electrical signals everywhere and receiving information from the outside world and generating our responses to what's going on in the outside world. This figure summarizes the four different types with a representative micrograph pointing to each. Epithelial tissue, like I said, lines the inside of a lot of organs or covers the outside. The example given here is the GI tract is lined with an epithelium, which is important for secreting digestive juices as well as absorbing nutrients out of the food that we're passing through the digestive tract. Connective tissues do a lot of different things. The example given here in the micrograph is fatty tissue, which helps for padding, say, the outside of the kidneys or the body in a number of different places, sometimes more than we'd like. But also, it's a source of energy storing the caloric-rich lipid molecules in our body. It also points to, in the figure, bones and tendons. Tendons are a great example of what connective tissue really means to be connecting things. Tendons hold muscles to bones. And then that brings us to muscle tissue. There are three major types, which we'll talk about in more detail later on. There's cardiac, smooth, and skeletal muscle. And then there's nervous tissue. Nervous tissue doesn't get classified quite the same way as the others. The regions that we see nervous tissue is in the brain or spinal cord, what we consider the central nervous system, as well as in the periphery as nerves and other structures. But they're all made of essentially the same components that make up nervous tissue. Tissues can be said to be collections of cells with specific properties that perform a particular function together. But it's important to consider the tissue that's made up of a few types of very specialized cells is really something that's adapted and derived from the ultimate single cell, the fertilized egg cell. in the process of differentiation from the fertilized egg cell, the cells become more and more specialized. At one time, there are three different types of tissue in the early growing embryo, called the ectoderm, the mesoderm, and endoderm. Now, in these words, derm basically means tissue, and ecto is outside, meso is middle, and endo is inside. Those three germinal tissues, the earliest tissues, will specialize into specific tissues in the body, and this table just gives an idea of several of them. The ectoderm is mostly interested in becoming the skin and major components of the nervous system. The mesoderm gives rise to most connective tissues and muscle tissue, as well as linings of certain empty spaces, certain epithelia derived from the mesoderm. And then the endoderm is responsible for giving rise to many of the other lining tissues, especially for the major organ tracts, like the digestive tract and the respiratory tract and that sort of thing. We'll see as we talk about some of these tissues later on that there are specific precursors that are recognized in the embryo, and they are important in defining some of those tissues. So from here we want to go on to talk about the specific classification of the different types of tissue and their subtypes. I'll split up the rest of what's going on here into the four major types of tissue and talk about each of their subtypes underneath them. For the laboratory component of this part of the course, we're going to be just concentrating on epithelial and connective tissues. We'll save muscle tissue and nervous tissue from a laboratory standpoint until we get to those parts of the course. So when we start the musculature, we'll look at muscle tissue in more detail, and when we get to the nervous system, we'll start by considering nervous tissue there. Consider this question. When you feel that you've reached an answer, hit the next button to go into the next slide, which will reveal the correct answer. The different types of tissue, when they were presented, were all associated with a general function for them. All of those things started with C, which might help you remember what they were. And nervous tissue is the one that's for communication. Now, there's some aspect of communication with on all four types of tissue, but really the nervous tissue is the one that's specialized for that in the electrical signaling that we see going on, receiving sensory information about the world around us and generating physical responses to what's happening around us.